Today, I'm going to show you how to, what is it called?
Make money
and sell out. Today, I'm going to show you how to vectorize art with image trace. Coming up.
Perfect.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. My name is Matt with Mikey Designs. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. We're going to dive right into this tutorial and show you how to vectorize art using auto or image trace in Adobe Illustrator. If you're in the market for Adobe Illustrator, use our link down in the description. What it will do is it will help support our channel, so that way we can continue to make videos such as these for you. Okay, so let's go ahead and dive right on into this tutorial. Let me pull up my webcam and we're still recording, her. Yes, we are. Okay, so here is the artwork that our client has provided. They have asked me to vectorize this art. So what we're going to do is we're going to quickly vectorize it, turn it out, and we'll make a little bit of money off of this. We'll show you how you guys can do that as well. You'll get requests from clients that want art vectorized, and here's a really quick and fast solution to be able to vectorize it. Okay, so here is the art that the client has provided. It is a PNG, so that is great. Obviously, you can see that it is white. So I'm going to show you how I would go about vectorizing this artwork, taking it from a pixel-based piece of artwork and turning it into vector. So one of the first things I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a look at the image size real quick. It is 10 inches wide by 3 inches high at 400 DPI. So that's great. It's a great piece of art to start out with. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to canvas size. And I think I'll just go ahead and make this an inch bigger by each dimension. And I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to make sure it just stays centered. And the reason for doing that is right here on the side. I'm going to hit undo, Command Z. If I left it this way and brought it into Illustrator, sometimes this can end up just being a flat edge. So we're going to go back by hitting Command Z, getting right back to where we were at. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to image mode. I'm going to turn it to grayscale. Now I'm going to hit Command I on the keyboard to inverse it. Now it's black. It will have a much better chance, or Illustrator will do a better job at vectorizing this once we bring it in as a JPEG with the white background and black text or black artwork, it'll just do a better job vectorizing it. So here we are. I'm just going to go ahead and flatten this. I'm going to go over here to my layers, click on this little icon here, and then we're going to go to flatten image. Now I'm going to take my zoom glass. I'm going to double click on this. You can see that the edges are pretty crisp, but one of the little tricks that you do want to do is I'm going to res this up. So that way there will be that much more information for Adobe Illustrator to be able to vectorize this piece of art. So I hit Command Option I. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm really going to crank up the resolution on this. I'm just going to go ahead and turn it to 1200 DPI. That will increase the size of this image big time. And that will allow us to vectorize this image and get a nice, crisp, clean, vectorized image. Now, if we were to zoom in here on some of these edges, you can see it's kind of feathered just a little bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Command L, and then we're just going to kind of compress this a little bit to get rid of some of that feathered edge. You can see that it's kind of disappeared a little bit. So I'm going to hit OK. This is pretty good. So now what we're going to do, I'm going to hit Command Shift and S. That is Save As for your quick command. You can just go to File and Save As. So we're just going to go ahead and save this as a TIFF. I'm going to put it inside my job folder. I like to keep things very organized. I'm not going to use any kind of compression or zip or anything like that. I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to hit Command W just to close this file out. We're all finished in Photoshop. Next thing we're going to do is hit Create New. You can hit Command N on the keyboard. And at this point, it will bring up a new document. And we'll just keep it letter size. We'll use that. And because it is a landscape logo, we'll just click on the landscape orientation here. I'm going to hit create. Hit command 0 real quick just to center this. Command shift and P. So that way we can place the artwork. Let's go find our artwork real quick. And here's the TIFF that we created. We're going to go ahead and place that inside the artboard or onto the artboard really quick. All I have to do is click and here we are. So the next thing I'm going to do, make sure this is selected, and we're going to click on image trace. And this will take a moment for it to trace it off. It's a really high resolution image. And you can see that it did a fairly good job tracing it off. However, there are some of these rounded edges. What we have to do at this point is we're going to click on this little box here. And this is going to bring up some of our options. I'm going to zoom back in on some of these hard edges. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase the threshold a little bit. See if it fills in some of these corners. Looks like it just made it a little bolder. One of the things we need to keep an eye on is what's going on with this registration mark here. So we might pull it back a little bit because it's starting to fill in here somewhat. So let's pull that back a little bit until it starts to look normal. And we're going to bump that up and just kind of play around with it a little bit. And we just don't want it to connect. So I think that's a good kind of medium point right there. Now with the paths, we're going to play with the paths. And if you do not see this on your computer, all you have to do is click this little drop down arrow here on your image trace palette, your window, your palette, whatever you want to call it. And we're going to play with some of these values here until it starts looking a little sharper. And you can go to each of the extremes, see what it does for you. Might even want to try and pull it all the way back. And there we go. That's looking a lot better. We got some pretty sharp edges here. Looks as if it's the actual real font. Paths here are nice and smooth. However, the only issue is this little circle R, but we'll get into that here in a moment. And perhaps this sign here. So one of the things that I do like to do, I'm going to evaluate this real quick. That looks great. So one of the things we can do, so I'm going to zoom out, or I'm just going to grab it and hold option and then hold shift. And we're going to clone that off real quick. I'm happy with the way this looks, this ampersand. You could use your the tracing results. You can fiddle around with some of these options and it will show you the outline versus what the actual image looks like. So the images that I had pulled off here over to the side, this is the one it's going off of. I mean, for the most part, this is looking pretty good. The reason I dragged this image off here is just because if for some reason this part of the logo wasn't looking all that great, some of the things you can do is you can clone these images off and then fool around with your values and take certain parts from one image trace and combine it with another. Some of the things that have kind of worked out really well. So at this point, the only thing that is looking kind of wonky is just the option R here. So let's click on this. We'll go back to the results with outlines. And we can see that our option, or excuse me, the registration mark looks a little goofy here. I'm going to go back to the original image. And we can see that that's not how it should appear. We know that's not how it should appear. So what I'm going to go ahead and do at this point is I'm going to hit expand. I'm going to hit A on the keyboard, click off of the art, click the white, go to select, same, and fill color. And what that will do is select the rest of these parts, like the inside of the fill of the P here and the O. We hit delete on the keyboard. Now, at this point, going to go ahead and get rid of that. I can hit V on the keyboard, get my little marquee tool back, my selection tool, excuse me. And we've got this vectorized pretty much for the most part, aside from this option R. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to hit T on the keyboard. I'm just going to click, hold option down and hit R. So there's our little option arm. You can change your fonts up. Let's say maybe we'll use Helvetica really quick. Tends to be a pretty good go-to. Perhaps maybe not bold, maybe regular. I'm going to hold Command, Shift, and hit O. That will turn it to outlines. And then we can scale this dude down. Looks like it probably should have been a bold, so I'm going to hit Command-Z to back up. Let's go to the bold. Really and truly, one of the things you could do as well is I could have taken this font here in Photoshop, selected this whole line, went over to what font is, and then just reset this whole font and redrew this. But this is a really quick, efficient way to vectorize your art. Command Shift and O. We converted that to outlines again. And I think that's close enough. Our clients won't be able to tell the difference. And I think this will work absolutely fine for these purposes. And we're getting the job done really quickly. So I hit Command X to cut that registration symbol. Now I'm double clicking on the image. So that way we're going with the insider group. And I'm just going to delete each of these by selecting them. Now I'm going to hit Command F to paste it in front. And there it is. I'm going to double click outside of the image area. And the art is all vectorized. We've taken a piece of pixel-based artwork and we have vectorized it. We hit Command Y and you can see that it is a piece of vector artwork. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I really do appreciate it. Be sure to subscribe. Hit my mug right over here in this little circle, this little icon, and we'll have some other videos. I'm always confused as to which direction or side it is on. If you are in the market for Adobe Photoshop or Illustrator, use our link down in the description. It will help support our channel. What it does is kicks a little bit of a commission our way, so that way we can continue to make videos such as these. Until next time, guys, we will see you later.